What is SeaPerch? SeaPerch is an underwater ROV competition, somewhat comparable to VEX or FIRST Robotics. In this competition, small groups of students get to design, create, and innovate their own ROV to compete in the International SeaPerch Competition. What makes SeaPerch stand out is one, it's all underwater, and two, you get to build your own controllers and waterproof your own motors. There's also a lot more freedom to innovate, in my opinion, which is my favorite part. Doing SeaPerch is a great way to learn and apply the engineering process, and you get to learn a lot of new skills that might come handy in the future, like soldering. My name is Hayden. I've done SeaPerch 2 years so far. I've gone to internationals both those times, and I did pretty well too. The point of this video series is for me to build a SeaPerch alongside of you. I'll share the easiest way to do things and other tips and tricks along the way. This is the first video in this series. So, what do these ROVs look like? Well, there are a few main parts. The frame is made of typically PVC pipe with three thrusters attached. Each thruster can spin in both directions. Two are horizontal, and the third is vertical. This allows for 3 degrees of freedom, movement forward and backward, up and down, and rotation on the vertical axis. Another thing that you will always find on a SeaPerch ROV is some form of buoyancy. Pool noodles are the most common. Lastly, ROVs need some way to actually do things in the water. This is usually a hook or a part of the frame, and this depends on the mission course, which we'll get to in a second. But first, there's one big point I want to stress here. There is no one correct frame or type of buoyancy or hook or thruster placement. SeaPerch allows you to try new things and invent new solutions. As I said earlier, the freedom to innovate is definitely my favorite part of SeaPerch. There are 4 main parts to the SeaPerch competition: 2 pool challenges and 2 out of pool challenges. First is the mission course. This is the only challenge that changes year to year. The mission course mainly entails moving and manipulating objects in the water. The idea is that you usually want to design your ROV around completing this challenge. The mission course from the 2021-22 season required ROVs to move floating objects, sinking objects, and to even open a door, so it had to be super versatile. The goal is to do everything as fast as possible without messing up. An example of messing up would be dropping an object on the pool floor, which means it's out of play. The other pool challenge is the obstacle course. There are 5 18-inch rings in the water that your ROV must swim through, each at different angles. After it's gone through all 5, the ROV must surface and then come back the way it came before touching the pool wall. Fastest time wins. The main consideration for this challenge is you have to make your ROV smaller than 18 inches in all dimensions. Otherwise, you won't be able to make it through all the rings. Making your ROV fast also helps. This can be done in many ways, such as making it lighter or more hydrodynamic. Out of the pool, the first challenge is to make a video explaining your ROV and all the design choices you've made, along with anything else you've done with your team to get to the point that you're at. Making your video fun and exciting is probably the best way to go. This is how I got second in my competition class in the 2022-23 season. The final challenge is your technical design report. This is just an in-depth paper about your ROV. I'm not going to lie, this isn't the most exciting part of the competition, but it's not that bad, especially if you have a team that can all pitch in. So, you want to do SeaPerch. What are the next steps for you? Well, that of course depends on your situation. Does your school have a SeaPerch club? If yes, great. Ask around for an interest meeting date and bring a few friends. Your school club is a great place to get support if you need it. If your school doesn't have a SeaPerch club, start your own. Or just do SeaPerch on the side when you have time. Whatever works for you. Now you gotta find a team. Teams are typically 3 people, and personally, I would never go over 4. You just wanna make sure that everyone can put in the time and stick to this commitment. If you think more than 4 can work, okay, but you've been warned. The tyranny of the majority is not fun, so make someone the captain. Typically, the person that can put in the most time and cares the most about this project. Team captain, you are responsible for keeping your team on track and getting your ROV built. You have the final say on issues, but if the ROV doesn't meet expectations, it's your fault. For this program, you get out as much as you can put in. It usually takes a few months to design, test, and build your ROV. Get started as soon as possible, and don't underestimate how long it will take to work out all of your ROV's problems. You can start designing your ROV with your team before the supplies arrive. More on that in a second. It's good to have a game plan in place so you can hit the ground running when you do get your supplies. The next step is to get you your stuff to build your ROV. Conveniently, SeaPerch offers an ROV build box on their website, seaperch.org. Inconveniently, it's $190. Conveniently again, it's not that hard to outsource the parts yourself, and it's much cheaper as well. So, especially if you have multiple teams so you can buy in bulk, outsourcing is a good option. The only downside is you can't get the circuit board that goes in the controller, which makes things a bit trickier. However, I go over how to circumvent this in my controller video. I'll show you how to solder the right wires together so you don't even need a circuit board. In the rest of this video series, I'm actually building an ROV alongside you from scratch, so go watch those when you're ready. Once your ROV is built, you'll have to test it in the water. A bathtub is okay, but a pool is 1,000 times better. Ask around for a place to test your ROV. Lots of hotels have pools, along with gyms and maybe a neighbor or two. It's better to find an option now than a few weeks before the competition. Speaking of the International SeaPerch Competition, there are two ways to get in. The first is to compete and excel at your regional competition. You can find your regional events on seaperch.org. If you don't do super well there, or you don't have a regional competition nearby, you can apply for a wild card spot on the website. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is about everything you can do to prepare for this SeaPerch season. As before mentioned, I have videos building a SeaPerch from scratch alongside you, explaining everything as I go. So 1, go join or create your own SeaPerch team. 2, think about a SeaPerch club for some extra support. 3, order everything to make your ROV, whether that be outsourcing or buying the SeaPerch build box. I go over everything you need in my build videos. 4, design a SeaPerch ROV with your team. If you need help, watch my video about frame design. And 5, find a pool. After that, go watch my other videos. See you there.